Here's the 20th best moments on TV that they forgot they were live and they did this. So if you guys do enjoy, please drop a like, subscribe to my channel, and let's get straight into today's video. What an embarrassing moment. This reporter gets confused between a butt and a boat. Obviously, he had some butts on his mind.
With another boatload of... a boatload of tourists ready to enjoy the long weekend.
We all know what they say, that you always speak what's on your mind. This reporter got confused between her name and his name.
Morning, thanks for joining us. I'm Kate Merrill.
I mean, I'm Chris McKinnon.
I am Kate Merrill. That is Chris McKinnon. And it is a Wednesday, Danielle, because somebody needs to get some sleep.
Wow.
That is the best TV moments since I've been here at WBC.
I've always wanted to be Kate. I texted that to Brianna last night. I said,
no,
I want to be Kate
Merrill.
No,
you don't.
Someday.
It is very complicated.
This is a very strange moment because the guy in the background dressed up as a swamp monster, oh, it's probably too cold outside. He's put too many coats on.
Let up at all. It is coming down pretty steadily here in Springfield. You can see that the visibility has been reduced. I've seen countless spin outs and
this weather guy tries to make a joke, but because it wasn't even that funny, the news anchor starts to laugh at him and his drawing.
Tell you what, we are not horsing around.
Okay. I was like, is it gonna be a bat? And then I was like, maybe it's gonna be a cat. I was thinking about like Halloween. I mean, you draw a horse in a second. Can't be easy.
My son could draw a horse.
Welcome to Monday, everybody. I'm trying to wake you up with a smile. Brandon's artwork sometimes hits the mark and sometimes not so much.
He hates us right
now. Well, I hate one of you, that's for sure. Let's go ahead and take
you.
A look at your temperatures on a Monday.
A very funny moment for news anchor gets confused between a bowl and a burrito. Because it was talking about burrito bowls, she thought you meant to eat the bowl, not the burrito.
Accommodates popular diets. There's a keto bowl, paleo bowl, whole 30 diet bowls. They all have big rules about what you can eat.
Oh, you mean those like the tortillas that they make when you order a bowl in our burrito? Is that what you're talking about?
No, you can get a bowl at Chipotle, just in a little bowl. And the certain ingredients go to a certain diet. How do you not know this?
I mean, I do, but I'm so confused about what you're talking about right now.
They're offering paleo diet friendly bowls. It has nothing to do with burritos. Just the stuff that's inside.
But why would you eat the bowl?
You don't eat the and when you have cereal, do you eat the bowl as well?
So what does it matter if it's paleo or not?
It's what's in the it's the ingredients. Oh my gosh. It's the chicken, the lettuce, those things. What's our weather?
This reporter gave it away on live TV that they were using green screens for the illusion.
With a look at what folks are actually seeing on the roadways all across our state, some of the worst hit areas. Adrian?
I get tired just walking from studio to studio.
This news anchor makes it awkward very quickly on live TV when she makes a few comments about Prince Harry's beard and his hair. One guy though on live TV wasn't that impressed. This news anchor has the giggles and he can't stop laughing at a small tree that got stolen.
Now to an impassioned plea in a string of thefts. Police are searching for several thieves believed to have stolen a 400-year-old bonsai tree. The missing tree seen here stands about 3 feet tall and 2.5 feet wide with more than 400 points and branches. It is.
They've raised this tree as their own child and they are desperate to have it home. It's estimated to be worth about $90,000.
She makes a joke on live TV that she's a gobbler, not a nibbler. Then both of them start to laugh. We all know what they meant.
I like to eat candy corn one color at a time. If you're really getting OCD
about
it, Well, I'm not always a nibbler. I'm kind of a gobbler.
There you go. She says on live TV it's her muff, but muff means something else around the world.
Wearing your Ugg boots on your hands. That's progressive.
Yeah, it's my muff. Mm-hmm. There we go.
Natalia's brought back the muff. It's very practical, the muff.
What are you talking about?
Carl's lost it,
Natalia. Keeping your hands warm.
This news anchor talks about sausage competition, that she tried different ones and judges them.
Sausage competition that I judge.
Oh, in like sausage eating?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. It's for charity, and you can get tickets online at Pick.
Oh, no. Well, you're thinking about sausage, so.
Pick a dick. Oh my God.
She was trying to act cool and do an awesome take, but it didn't go to plan.
This gym is temporary. It's going to be here for a few years, and right now students say that is more than enough for them, because this gym is a home run. Students say that this gym is a grand slam, but this gym is nothing but net.